Hey guys, Bobby Gass here. That's hot. This is, I'm gonna kill a bunch of birds with this shotgun blast of a video. It was supposed to be a friendship video for Z and some VCLT I'm sending and some new records. It's a whole bunch of stuff here, guys, so let's get started. Anyhow, the friendship video was for Bobby Z. Now, I had done a video, and then I was just about to put it up, and then he did a video where he said he took down his lottery contest. Jenny took that over for him, I believe. And he took down his contest video, you know, why you like him, and, you know, something like that, right? And so I deleted it, and I told him I deleted it. And next thing I know, he's doing a video where he's saying that the friendship video was on. So, you know, I put that one in my watch later thing, and I'm going to do it before the end of the month. And so I do another video. But I don't know the rules, so I have to go back to his video to see what date I have to put it up on and see, make sure I got everything right on my video. And I go back to Z's channel, and he got rid of all his videos because of that kid's, I don't know, Costco or what the hell's the name of that new rule about videos. Anyhow, he deleted, they're all gone, so I had to delete two videos in a row. About that, I've watched a number of videos about that, you know, people are all freaked out about it, you know. It doesn't affect anybody up here in Canada. It's just a rule down in the States. And I don't know what you guys are so freaked out about. I mean, I did an awful lot of, they're not going to find you no $42,000. They're trying to get molesters, kid porn guys, right? And if you ain't one of them things, what the fuck are you worried about? Anyhow, he's to the wrong guys. I mean, they're not scared or anything else like that. I was going to put up my Christmas tree over there and all my Christmas decorations for his video, but, you know, I was even going to, you know, display my SpongeBob. He really likes a SpongeBob, but it's got rips in it now up on the top, and it doesn't, oh, there's a little fart out of it. That's a surprise. It's got coffee stains on it now, and, you know, he's been around now. Z's been trying to get this off me for 5 years. He texted me the other day, too, eh? So I know the kid's alive, right? He did send me, you know, years ago, this box set of the Rolling Stones, and he knows I'm a Stones fan, and, you know, in a big Stones book. And so that's your friendship video. You stupid. Knock all your videos off. Man, oh man, oh man. Anyhow, the records I got, right? Steve Carlson. I was calling him Carlton. He recommended, I don't know, a week or two ago or a couple of weeks ago, a month ago, a band called The Chains. These guys are out of Montreal, and you see that little barcode down there? That means it's a new album from the 2000s. Anyhow, I got some records here. Listen to some of the music thingy, right, of The Chains, right? Here you go, guys, The Chains. It's not bad. It's not the best rock and roll in the world. It's worth buying, though, eh, if you like this kind of music. There you go. We'll be right back. here's some 45s I picked up, you know, on the internet. Hey, I can't grab, you know, I go to a store and I don't have the 45, you know. Anyhow, let's go with the 45s here. First up, I never seen this, never seen anything like this before. It's a Birds EP, Lover on the Bayou. I really like that one. And Do You Want to Be a Rock and Roll Star? Of course, you know, everybody knows that one there. And on the flip side here is Going Back and Crimes of Freedom. Never seen one of these before, so I had to grab it, right? And we'll listen to a little bit of it.
Ladies and gentlemen, right, let's have a fine hand for the Birds.
I'm the lover of the bayou. Mark your doorstep with a halfway ride. I'm the lover of the bayou.
Some of their music, like all bands, I like some music and some music I don't. Even the Stones, even James Brown. Here's Memphis by Johnny Rivers on the old Liberty label. No, International, on the old International label. Johnny Rivers, he had a hell of a lot of hits on the top 40, top 50. You'd be surprised. I bet you dozens, I bet. Dozens. Now here's Shrinks on a True North, a Canadian label. They're a Canadian band that I believe was the first band to use a Moog here in Canada. This is about 1970. It's okay. I just got it because it's, you know, the first Moog tune. Nothing special. Here's Let's Dance by Chris Montes. This is an English copy right here. British copy. I remember this when this tune was out, there used to be at our dance a sock hops, they used to call them. It was on a gymnasium floor, and the janitor didn't want you marking up the hardwood floor with your leather shoes and sneakers, so you had to wear socks, and that's why they called them sock hops. And there was these two girls, two Italian girls, I don't know, 12, 13, whatever, you know, at these dances. It was a public school, you know, grade 7 and grade 8s. And they used to dance to this song. Every time this song come up, they would dance, free dance. And they would get, you know, here and here, and then they would start dancing, and then they'd start backing up, and then they'd move together, dancing, and they'd actually move to opposite ends of the... of the gymnasium, and then starting dancing together, right? And these girls, they were buxom girls, you know. Italian girls grew up a little earlier than the Canadian girls, and all us guys are. Every time I hear this song, I just think of that, those two girls. I never remember their name. Here's a French pressing, Aeroplane, September in the Rain, and It's So Better, on the Pink Elephant label. That's a French one. This one here is kind of like you know, hippy dippy flower power stuff from the days, maybe a little psych to it. And this one here, I ordered this, and as you can see, there's no address on it, because I actually ordered this, I took my address on it, I actually ordered this for somebody in the VC, and well, I've done it, you know, I sent some stuff to Bobby Z, some white label promos that he's starting to dig, and I sent something to Panix, Led Zeppelin ticket stuff, because he's a Led Zeppelin fan, and I got something for Robbo, you know, my buddy. These are for the people that contact me all the time, you know, correspond with me and stuff like that. I feel, a little more friendship towards them than other people. I mean, when anybody's trying to engage with you, naturally, you know, you're feeling a little closer to them, right? Anyhow, this is for, and when I open this up, the person's probably going to know it. Neil Young, Wondering and Paola Blues. It just so happens to be a white label promo, not a Canadian white label promo, not for sale. This is for Lisa. Ellie, she loves Neil Young. I think she'd park her boots under his bed. This is for you, Lisa, but I don't have the address. So you're going to have to, I know how freaked out you are about people sending you stuff through the mail that you don't know nothing about, so you're going to have to send me your address. Now, a couple of months ago, it was you or a scammer asked me on my on a comment for my, you know, the mail, what do you call that, mail thingy you do on the computer? You asked me for my email address, right? And I gave it to you. Now, I don't know whether, I never got a, you know, an answer from you or anything else like that. But anyhow, you get me your address, and this will be going out to you, kid. And along with that, I got something for Robbo. Oh, wait a minute. Let's show you a little bit of Neil Young here.
This one's for you, Alan Freed. Wherever you go. Whatever you do, because the things that doing today will make a scene out of you.
Catch your water, catch your water,
Paola Blues.
Catch your water, catch your water.
I got the Paola Blues, even though I already paid my dues. Listen to me, Mr. DJ, hear what I got to say. If a man is making music, they ought to let his record play. Get it on. Thanks a lot, man. I love your new song.
Catch your water, water. Catch your water,
hey, old
water. Catch your water, water. Catch your water, water.
No matter where I go,
crazy. Baby, you've been gone so long, I'm wondering if you'll come home. I'm hoping that you'll be my baby. I'm wondering if I'll be alone, knowing that I need you to save me.
Bravo. That's Paul Henderson. You guys might not know who Paul Henderson is, but Robbo knows who Paul Henderson is. He bleeds blue just like I do. I'll tell you, I'll show you who Paul Henderson is.
Almost every day of my life, a Canadian will come up to me and shake my hand and say, you know, thank you for one of the greatest thrills of my life.
Back to Henderson.
2-0. All was right in Canada.
It was very, very important for me to put these Russians in their place. I mean, they were the big bad Russians, and they were, this was, I mean, Canada, this is the one thing that we are the best at.
Henderson for Canada centers out to Ellis, who tries to score! Hart deflected that one into the net.
Montreal's 7-3 win changed their mandate. Now they were instructed to win it all. And while they enjoyed Canadian hospitality, they churned inside. The pause in action allowed for some ice-breaking, but everyone was obsessed with what had happened.
The worst thing is to overestimate yourself and underestimate your opposition.
And now Lebedev is dumped by Henderson. Here's Canada coming in out of break.
Shades of what would come. Canada's last goal, Paul Henderson.
From the faceoff, the puck slides into the Canadian zone. 6:18 remaining in the second period. Here's a loose puck for Henderson. Right in.
The score remained 4-4 through the final period. We played on pure instinct and raw courage, but the game was slipping away. When chance appeared, Tretiak closed the door. Canadians, 3,500 strong. They became a factor in stark contrast to the impassive Moscow bureaucrats who gobbled up the Luzhniki tickets. 9 minutes later, Paul Henderson's star in ascent. He made it 3-0. The thrown-together line of Henderson, Clark, and Ellis hit stride. Then, in a moment, it was nearly pulled apart.
The defenseman tripped me, and it spun me around, and I was going at full tilt, and I knew I was going to go into the boards. I was out cold. Joe Scrow, the trainer, told me, came out and he broke three of the ammonia packs under my nose even before I came around. And I was totally out of it.
The crowd was gripped in shocked silence. Henderson summoned courage as the game went on. By the intermission, he'd made up his mind.
You know, I was crying. I said, Harry, you've got to let me play. And so he looked at the doctor, and the doctor says, well, you know, he says, I can't stop you, but he says, I'm telling you, you probably should not play. You know, you got a slight concussion. And I said, well, you know, let's go. And so Harry said, okay. And so we went back out.
Clark takes a long pass to Henderson. He's in the clear. Right in on the goal. He just scores! Henderson! From Clark. A beautiful set of play by Clark. And Henderson came back from the victory to score his second goal of the night. Here's why it's so important to headman the puck. Henderson was breaking on his wing. He had a lot of ice. Bobby Clark put the dump pass way up into the middle. Henderson skates on top of it and walks in all alone and drills another goal by Tretiak.
And two of the three have been added starters. Now there's Canada coming up. It's good to go! Henderson! Let's go with a long drive. And Canada takes the 2-goal lead.
2 minutes left. Cue Paul Henderson.
Tried to make a little move and lost the puck off the guy's skate. He came over, kicked it in behind, and I felt myself going down, and I looked up, and there was only one place to put it, and that was right under the bar. And boy, it went under the bar, and I'll tell you, one of the greatest feelings. And you know, when I watched the replay today, I mean, if there's any one goal that I could sit there and watch for 2 hours, it's that goal I scored in the seventh game.
Two must-win games, and for Henderson, two game winners.
It will never again be the same as it was in 72. The series with Canada was an historic affair, forever inscribed in the history of the game. It was also critical towards developing hockey throughout Europe and the world.
102 left in the game.
All who watched remember exactly where they were. A hush fell across our land.
I really had a sense that I could score a goal. I started yelling at Peter Mihailovic to come off the ice, and for some reason, Peter did come off. As Peter came over to the bench, I was looking at the play, of course, and as I jumped over the boards, I saw that Yvonne Cornway had the puck at the far boards, and I immediately started yelling Yvonne as hard as I could. The Russian defenseman by this time had come out to reach me, and I fell. I got up, of course, being aware of the play. I saw that Phil Esposito was going to intercept a pass. And before I even had time to yell at Phil, he just whacked it at Tretiak right here. I got the puck and I tried to immediately shoot it along the ice into the corner of the goal. Tretiak stopped it with his pad. The puck came right back to me. He was down and out. And I had about a foot to put it in. I turned and Yvonne Cornway was there and I jumped into his arms, gave him a bear hug, and then Big Phil came around and the three of us were there.
Cornway has it on that wing. Here's a shot! Henderson made a wild stab for spell. Here's another shot!
Well, that's all she wrote, gang. I got a whole bunch of stuff done there, right? Well, adios. Time to saddle up and hit the trail.